Good morning, afternoon, and good evening, everyone. Today, we'll be taking a look into the history of music therapy and its positive effects on memory. The general public might know of music therapy, but when we peel back the layers and analyze the scientific aspects, it proves to be quite complex. So sit back, take a drink of water, and let's get this psychological show on the road. The origins of neuroscience, the field in which music therapy is associated with, can be traced back all the way to the time of the ancient Greeks. Hippocrates, who is considered the father of Western medicine, declared that the brain not only regulated sensation, but was also the source of emotion, thought, and comprehension. The Greek people not only valued the physical self, valuing their athletic abilities with events such as the Olympics, but also the mental self. Socrates believed that arts can and should be therapeutic. Though there were detractors from this philosophy, Socrates' work and philosophy still rings true in Western societies, even to this day. Fast forward to the 20th century. Veterans from the horrifying conflicts in World War II are treated with group therapy. Among these therapy methods lies the art of music therapy. Music therapy was thought to help the soldiers associate themselves with their brothers in arms, reminding them of songs sang in brotherhood and not of the horrifying acts inflicted upon each other in the war. As scientists gathered more data from brain imaging the World War II veterans, musicians were employed at various hospitals across the nation. These musicians would play concerts for wounded veterans as the scientists observed the data gathered from brain imaging. What they found was that music serves as a therapeutic device to ease soldiers' minds, in line with the thesis that Socrates put forward. A great takeaway from these findings is that we know for certain that music holds an inherent therapeutic trait. What could be even more interesting, however, is an analysis of the different genres of music and how they sway a person's mood. Perhaps light classical music provides a more valuable tool for studying than heavy metal music would, helping a student to retain the memory of their studious efforts. Human memory is, unfortunately, a fickle thing. Often, we don't really think about how bad our memory actually is, fragmented, disjointed, incomplete. An unfortunate truth in life is that as we grow older, our memory and retention of knowledge declines. This decline can be exacerbated by a number of different conditions. We've all experienced it, that sensation of a loved one forgetting a conversation you cherished with them. It's important to analyze the traits of depression and dementia on congruent memory. That is, when humans store memories, they not only store the event, but also store the memory of the mood they were in at the time. For this reason, when we feel happy, we recall other happy memories. It has been widely proved that cognitive dysfunctions are a primary characteristic of schizophrenia. Major alterations have been identified in attention, memory, and executive functions in the schizophrenic population. While a cure for schizophrenia is nowhere in sight, there are many actions we can take to both help lessen the symptoms and possibly even prevent them from happening. In 2015, a group of scientists evaluated the topics of matter and making in music therapy. In this study, patients were asked to recount and recreate a hand position shown in a series of images. One group recreated the image presented without listening to music, while the others listened. What they found was that music helps recreate physical memory in the muscles. So what's the takeaway here? Well, as stated previously, congruent memory allows a person to remember more thoughts that align with a certain mood, even in schizophrenic patients. Music also enhances one's ability to remember physical traits and images and recreate them. So imagine the good that can come from regular music therapy sessions in depressed elderly members. The possibilities of the mind are limitless. Take, for example, a father in his late 80s suffering from dementia. Though his family lives away from him and he may live in a home for the elderly, imagine a music therapist regularly visiting him. Perhaps he plays a song played at the man's wedding and spurs a sprain into his step. It may start small, but the possibilities are endless. Part of the brain that music directly affects is in the occipital lobe, found on the back of the brain. The occipital lobe is also responsible for retaining the images of what we see. A common theory is that some expert musicians are able to visualize the notes that they are playing and also visualize the ones they listen to while listening to other people's music. So, if the brain responds so positively to music, why is music therapy not a more common practice? It could be utilized heavily in schools, as students found to be excellent with grades are often musically gifted as well. The practice and repetition of learning an instrument could benefit non-musical students pretty greatly. Imagine the possibilities of all the good that could be done when you have younger students learn these skills ahead of time. Not only is therapy becoming more and more popular, But music therapists are also being hired at a far more increased rate than in the past. Preparing students for the future is, after all, what we should do best. In tandem with music therapy, patients should also seek out sociable support from other patients. In a group setting, it can be easier to talk about one's feelings and frustrations with an anonymous group to vent to. Similar to the concept of AA meetings, group musical therapy sessions could benefit patients of all ages and backgrounds. Human beings are pack animals by nature. We surround ourselves with those that make us uncomfortable. What music can provide to these kinds of environments is unparalleled. In a group musical therapy session, we see patients come out of their shells, reigniting a spark in their eyes long thought lost to time. This information is paramount to pass on to the next generation. What we learn as adults should be expanded upon in the future. Obviously, strides will be made with music therapy far after our generation has handed over the reins, but only if we normalize musical therapy to begin with. The future is bright for music therapy. Its positive effects on memory and mood shouldn't be underestimated and need to be implemented into more kinds of therapy for patients. Mental health isn't a thing to scoff at, especially in the elderly or those that may exhibit memory loss. With music therapy, we can teleport back to that time on the beach, watching the sunset with friends, listening to our favorite songs. This presentation used references from the 2006 article by Cesato and Caniva, a 2015 article by Gilbertson, and a 1998 article by Suzuki.